families and friends. Welcome to the 132nd commencement of American International College. Please rise and join in celebration as we present the Parade of Nations honoring the home countries of our graduating international students. Please remain standing as the Parade of Nations will immediately be followed in procession by the American International College graduating class of 2017.
Damas y caballeros, familiares y amigos, bienvenidos a la 132ª ceremonia de graduación del American International College. Por favor, póngase de pie y únanse a la celebración a medida que presentamos la parada de las naciones en oro a los países de nuestros graduandos internacionales. Por favor, manténgase de pie luego de la parada de las naciones, ya que esta será seguida por la procesión de la clase graduanda 2017 del American International College.
Representing the United States of America, Student Body President Rebecca Gray, Class of 2017, Student Commencement Speaker Antoine Bluster, and National Anthem Singer Rachel Perlin.
Representando a los Estados Unidos de América, la Presidenta del Cuerpo Estudiantil, Rebecca Gray, Clase 2017, el estudiante orador de la ceremonia de graduación, Antoine Bluster, y la intérprete del himno nacional, Rachel Perlin.
Representing Brazil, Isabella Ochowski Doubt and Andre Rolim.
Representando Brasil, Isabella Ochowski Doubt y Andres Rolling.
Representing the Bahamas, Kimel Cartwright.
Representando las Bahamas, Kimel Cartwright.
Representing Canada, Alexandra Isabella Stasek.
Representando Canadá, Alexandra Isabella Stasek.
Representing Denmark, Lassie Blot O'Rip.
Representando Dinamarca, Lassie Blot O'Rip.
Representing France, Jessica Theatine and Margareta. Anaïs Cherion.
Representando a Francia, Jessica Thuitin, Margaret y Anaïs Cherion.
Representing Greece, Eliana Anna Fulop.
Representando Grecia, Eliana Anna Fulop.
Representing Ireland, Mitchell Byrne.
Representando a Irlanda, Mitchell Byrne.
Representing Kenya, Pascaline Jeretic and John Cheer.
Representando a Kenya, Pascaline Jeretic and John Cheer.
Representing Serbia, Natalia Kruger.
Representando a Serbia, Natalia Kruger.
Please join in welcoming the faculty of American International College.
Por favor, demos juntos la bienvenida a la facultad del American International College.
Okay, please applaud the students of American International College.
Démosle un aplauso a la clase graduanda 2017 del American International College.
Please continue congratulating our American International College students.
Vamos a continuar felicitando a nuestra clase graduanda 2017 del American International College.
Please applaud the students of American International College.
Familiares y amigos, démosles las felicitaciones a los graduandos de la clase 2017 de American International College.
Please applaud the students of American International College.
Por favor, démosles un aplauso a la clase graduanda 2017 del American International College. Démosle la bienvenida a los estudiantes de la clase graduanda 2017 del American International College.
Please join in welcoming the faculty of American International College.
Por favor, demos juntos la bienvenida a la facultad del American International College.
Join in welcoming our stage party for today's ceremony.
Ahora demos juntos la bienvenida a las autoridades institucionales y a los decanos de las diferentes facultades del American International College que nos estarán acompañando en esta ceremonia de graduación.
Thank you.
please remain standing, and men, remove your caps for the national anthem of the United States of America. The Star Spangled Banner will be sung by Rachel Perlin, who is graduating with a Bachelor of Science in Nursing.
Por favor, permanezcan de pie, y les quiero pedir a todos los caballeros que se remuevan sus sombreros para escuchar el himno nacional de los Estados Unidos de América, The Star Spangled Banner, que será interpretado por Rachel Perlin, graduanda del Bachillerato de Ciencias en Enfermería.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Father John McDonough, Coordinator of Campus Ministry Outreach, Diocese of Springfield, will now lead the invocation. Please remain standing until after the invocation.
Padre John McDonough, Coordinador del Campus Ministry Outreach de la Diócesis de Springfield, nos dirigirá en la invocación. Por favor, manténgase en de pie hasta que termine la invocación.
Gracious God, known in many names and heard in many voices, we ask your presence with us. These soon-to-be graduates will step up these stairs to graduate. It not been step after step, hasn't it? They're not the same people who came to American International College for an undergraduate or graduate degree. Their discoveries transformed them, and we rejoice with them in their accomplishments. They learn in ways they not only anticipated, but also discovered insights in the middle of pain and difficulties. I ask them to pause for a moment and remember one person who was with them in a challenge, in a setback, and quietly name that person, maybe a father, a mother, a spouse, an aunt, an uncle, a grandparent, an AIC coach or professor, an administrator, somebody from student affairs, a staff person, a classmate or friend who made all that difference in that challenge. Quietly hold that person by name in your heart for a moment. Thank that person and the Lord for the blessing she or he has been, and for the many other blessings. Be with us, Lord, as we celebrate the achievement of these soon-to-be graduates from American International College. Amen.
Please be seated. It is my pleasure to introduce the president of American International College, Dr. Vincent M. Mariachi.
Por favor, tomen asiento. Es un placer presentarles al presidente del American International College, el Dr. Vincent M. Mariachi.
Good afternoon. I am Vince Mariachi, president of American International College, and I welcome you to our 132nd commencement. Today, we recognize the undergraduate and graduate students who will receive their respective degrees. I thank you for what you have contributed to the AIC community over your course of studies. Your involvement has added immeasurably to the scholarship and ongoing value of the college. I would like to thank the members of the Board of Trustees for their total commitment and support to the college and to me. Your work is deeply appreciated. I also thank the members of the faculty and administration for their support and fine work in making this another successful year. Further, I extend my warmest congratulations to the parents, family members, loved ones, and friends who are present to bear witness and to help celebrate this joyous milestone in the lives of the degree recipients. We now have a brief video for you to enjoy.
The edge of the water, long as I can remember, never really knowing why. I wish I could be the perfect daughter, but I come back to the water, no matter how hard I try. Every turn I take, every trail I track, every path I make, every road leads back to the place I know, where I cannot go, where I long to. Telling how far I'll go.
Congratulations to each and every one of you. I wish you continued success in all of your future endeavors. Know that you will always have a place at AIC and a place in my heart. Thank you.
Please welcome Dr. Frank Colaccini, Chair of the Board of Trustees of American International College.
Por favor, demos la bienvenida al Dr. Frank Colaccini, Director de la Junta Directiva del American International College.
Thank you. Congratulations, graduates, your families, honorary degree, honorary doctorate degrees candidates, and faculty. Congratulations to you all. Now, Mr. President, by the powers, rights, and privileges granted to the Board of Trustees of American International College, by the Commonwealth of Massachusetts in 1885, I hereby authorize you to confer upon the candidates here assembled the degrees or certificates for which they have been respectfully qualified by the faculty and certified by the registrar.
Mr. Chairman, members of our distinguished faculty, certificate and degree candidates, honored guests, and all in attendance, let the commencement of American International College proceed. Mr. Jack Dill, please present the candidate for the Honorary Doctor of Commercial Science.
Mr. President, I have the high honor of presenting to you James C. Hagen for the honorary degree of Doctor of Commercial Science. Way to go indeed. James C. Hagen, MBA 88, American International College alumnus, we honor you today for your commitment to the philanthropic activities and for your community service with institutions throughout the greater Springfield area. For more than 30 years, that has taken place. You graduated from American International College in 1988 with your Master's of Business Administration degree after earning your Bachelor of Science degree in Business Management from Westfield State University in Westfield, Massachusetts in 1984. In 2005, your expertise in credit analysis, commercial lending, and administration at several New England-based banking institutions led to your appointment as President and Chief Operating Officer of Westfield Bank and to your promotion to Chief Executive Officer of that same institution in 2009. You have strived to strengthen and expand the scope of Westfield Bank's Future Fund, a philanthropic fund dedicated to supporting educational, recreational, cultural, and social service programs and projects affecting children throughout the greater Springfield and northern Connecticut areas. Your unwavering commitment to the needs of community-based initiatives has contributed to the continued success of such vital area institutions as the Boys and Girls Clubs, the Make-A-Wish Foundation, numerous YMCA facilities, the Ronald McDonald House of Springfield, and senior centers, schools, and hospitals throughout the region. Your commitment to youth athletic organizations as coach for Westfield Babe Ruth Baseball, Westfield Suburban Basketball, and Westfield United Soccer has helped foster the values of determination, integrity, and hard work to generations of young men and women, while also serving as trustee of Westfield Technical Academy and the Greater Westfield Babe Ruth League. Your further commitment to social and cultural institutions in the Springfield area can be seen in the work you have done on the board of directors for Bay State Noble Hospital and Stanley Park of Westfield, as well as your work on the Finance Council of St. Mary's Parish in Longmeadow, Massachusetts. You have accomplished much, improved the lives of many, and continue to set an example for all who know you. Among other honors, you have previously been named Westfield Business Person of the Year in 2005, were selected as a Community Leader Award recipient of the Western Mass Association of Fundraising Professionals, were elected to the Westfield Boys and Girls Club Wall of Fame, and were named an Outstanding Community Spirit Award honoree by the American Red Cross Greater Westfield Chapter. We are proud to join the many others who have honored you in giving thanks for all that you are and all that you do.
James C. Hagen, by virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of American International College, I hereby confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Commercial Science honoris causa with all of the rights, honors, and privileges pertaining thereunto. Dr. Frank Colacino, please present the candidate for the Honorary Doctor of Laws.
Mr. President, I have the high honor of presenting to you Judge Mark G. Mastriani for the honorary degree of Doctor of Laws. Mark G. Mastriani, BA in 86, American International College alumnus, former trustee, we honor you today for your continued commitment to upholding the fair and impartial administration and enforcement of the law for all people, epitomizing the strength of our nation's most sacred and vital foundations. You graduated magna cum laude from American International College in 1986 with your Bachelor of Arts degree in both English and political science. Your dedication to academic excellence brought you several honors, including the college's Outstanding Senior Award, Outstanding Achievement in History Award, and Outstanding Achievement in Political Science Award, as well as induction into the National Honor Society in 1985. After graduating with your Juris Doctorate degree in 1989 from Western New England University School of Law, you began your career at the Hampden County District Attorney's Office, working as a prosecuting trial attorney from 1990 to 1995, and transitioned to the private practice of law from 1995 until the end of 2010, specializing in criminal defense litigation in both state and federal courts. In November 2010, you won the general election for District Attorney of Hampden County, overseeing a staff of nearly 150 people across numerous courts throughout the county, serving the 23 towns and cities that make up Hampden County in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. In addition to litigating several homicide cases to successful verdicts, you instituted programs focusing on the use of DNA and modern forensic technology to successfully investigate previously unsolved murders and cold cases, and began community outreach efforts to raise awareness of issues faced by diverse members of the community, including elders, school-aged children, and those in high-crime neighborhoods. Citing your impressive legal career, wide-ranging respect, and strong ties to the community, Senator Elizabeth Warren, with a strong endorsement from Congressman Richard Neal, recommended you to President Barack Obama to fill a judicial vacancy in the United States District Court, a nomination that he made in September of 2013. With President Obama stating that your nomination, and I quote, demonstrated the talent, expertise, and fair-mindedness Americans expect and deserve from their judicial system. The Senate Judiciary Committee began their vetting procedure, and in February 14, the Senate Committee conducted a full hearing on your judicial nomination, and concluding with a recommendation to approve. In June of 2014, the full Senate confirmed the President's nomination by a 92-2 vote. You have accomplished much, improved the lives of many, and continue to set an example as a pillar in your community. Among other honors, you received the Kent B. Smith Award for Achievement and Dedication to the Advancement of the Practice of Criminal Law in June of 2011. And in 2013, received the Massachusetts Missing Children's Day Award for contribution and service to that cause. In 2015, the Western New England University School of Law awarded you their Distinguished Alumni Award. Now, by the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of American International College, I hereby confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Laws, honoris causa, with all the rights, honors, and privileges pertaining thereto.
Mark G. Mastriani, by virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of American International College, I hereby confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Laws, honoris causa, with all of the rights, honors, and privileges pertaining thereunto.
Congratulations, graduates 2017. Thank you so much to the college and to the Board of Trustees for inviting me here today to address you. I feel now and have always felt such a strong connection to this college. I never thought that when I graduated from here back in 1986 that I might be asked back to give a graduation address. I am completely humbled by this invitation. AIC taught me some very important things, and one of the most important things I learned very early on was not to allow the world's assumptions about you define or affect how you develop your potential and individual capacity. I also learned that oftentimes the world's assumptions about you and what you can do are brought on and molded by what your own assumptions are about yourself. Within everyone, there are feelings of doubt about something, of insecurity about something. But there are also pockets of confidence that we all have, but don't just put out there for display. You know, or should get to know, who you are and appreciate what you can do. You and only you define, expand, limit your own personal potential. You decide it. But realize that life, that is, the outside world you need to navigate, reacts and interacts with you based upon what you give it to work with. My own story started with a presumption that I wasn't suited for college, which would have been perfectly fine with me, except that I had decided I wanted to go. I admit that I caused that presumption to be formed, and I had some doubts about my own readiness for the academic environment. AIC, however, saw something in me. I was just only starting to see that in myself. AIC gave me an opportunity, which I seized upon and took full advantage of. Nothing that you did in the past can define you unless you want that to continue to be the definition of who you are. Don't feel uncertain or anxious if you have some self-doubt or confusion about what comes next for you. Feel completely normal and feel empowered. There is immense power in coming to know yourself and what you can do. Recognize that self-critique and even self-doubt can be, but doesn't have to be, self-defeating. Always take a realistic self-evaluation. Be brutally honest with yourself. But knowing who you are now does not mean you will know or even recognize the person in the mirror down the road in your life. Never try to sell yourself excuses about what you think you can't do. You have to be your own motivational speaker, your own motivational source every day. Have a healthy and big ego that you humbly and quietly keep inside of you, that ego that builds you up and keeps you convinced of your great potential, talent, and self-worth. However, as a warning, never let that turn into arrogance, as arrogance is a character flaw that exposes a lack of personal substance and integrity. You have to nurture your true being and cultivate your own strengths, interests, and passions, and your own hopes for the future, while being aware of your own fears and vulnerabilities, but somehow making it all work. You indeed are a complicated person. Life is complex. It requires and builds character to recognize that you need to stay true to the inner person that you are. But there's also another person that has to put themselves out into the world. Sometimes the true essence of who you are is what you let the world see. But more often, there are variations of that person which you actually project publicly. You must balance all of this. You don't surrender to the difficulty or complexity of making that balance work. You just have to make it happen. You will realize the joy and challenge of going through life is to constantly be working to bring that complex life of yours in balance, while realizing the great and engaging thing about life is that perfect balance is never possible to achieve. As graduating students, you are likely uncertain about what you will do, but must appreciate that rarely do people have detailed plans about what kind of career they will have or what they will accomplish. Life will move and life will direct you. Your primary responsibility to yourself is to be open and accepting that it's all part of your balancing act. You can learn to love the process of committing yourself to things, investing yourself, motivating yourself. Even if you never wanted or thought you would be doing a certain thing in your life, you must put everything that you have into doing that certain thing. It's that process itself that you will learn to love. There is nothing wrong with, and I highly recommend, becoming obsessed with things. Anything you want to succeed at, make it an obsession. Even if you ultimately find out that particular thing doesn't work for you, then move on. Move on to the next thing that you want to become obsessed with. Stay ready, graduates. Stay ready. Opportunities are going to arise for you at the most unexpected of times. When they do, you have to be ready to seize them. You have to jump on them. You have to dare failure. You have to dare change. You have to dare pushing your own boundaries. Dare to protect yourself only as much as you really have to. There is a way in your balancing act to calculate risk and to push just a little bit at the edges of your own comfort zone. With each push, you expand your comfort zone and you learn more about yourself and you become braver and wiser. So graduates, what does the world have in store for you? Really? It's similar to what the world has had in store for people your age, generations before you. It should not be daunting to you, but it's understandable if you feel that way. The following are some observations referenced to graduating students in the years preceding you. These thoughts to graduating students that came before you help them prepare to make a difference in the world, just like you will be doing. And some of these observations ring true today and are just as appropriate to state in 2017 as they were when the remarks were made to the respective graduating classes. The first comment is, as you view this world of which you are about to take a more active part, I have no doubt that you have been impressed by its chaos. Although applicable today, that was spoken in 1932. This country has profound, pressing social problems on its agenda. In 1969, that was spoken, and the students were encouraged to bring their energies to the solving of those problems. There is a trend of deterioration and despair, of crime and unemployment, of pollution and bad housing, and of drugs causing people to be sick with addiction. Although it sounds like it's applicable, that was spoken at a 1975 graduation. You're an adult. You're an adult at a time when leaders of the world are behaving like children. As true as that may ring for you today, that was told to a graduating class in 1980. you graduating students can work to bring about a day when the rich and privileged have to live by the same standards as the poor and outcast. More than anything, poverty threatens the domestic tranquility of our nation, as we as a society do not take care of those with less. True in 1998 when it was spoken, and true today. In 2009, it was spoken by Barack Obama at a graduation. It was spoken by Mr. Obama. He said, "It is a difficult world. You must endeavor to build a better future that deals with climate change, worldwide suffering, poverty, economic uncertainty, and political disagreements." Now, this puts into perspective for you what graduating classes before you were facing. Like you, all of these graduating classes between 1932 and 2009 had enormous challenges. They, as you will do, rose to the challenge and responded by bringing their energy, creativity, commitment, hard work, and dedication towards making the world a better place. A very good argument can be made that many of the issues currently facing our country, and indeed our world, are more complex now than ever before. Some recurring problems, and you heard the themes, may never completely go away, but it is the noble and right effort to continue to push back against those problems, to always seek to do better, to prepare yourself to make a difference. Students, graduating students, answer for yourself the question posed in a song which considered the serious societal issues in the early 1970s. The question is, when it's time to function as a feeling human being, will your Bachelor of Arts help you get by? Getting a degree or multiple degrees does not simply or automatically make you a better person. But realize that earning what you have earned does give you a resource that you can choose to use responsibly and conscientiously as you move forward in your life. Graduating students accomplish things on a grand scale or on a small scale. Accomplishments provide wonderful life moments, but don't end your journey of achievement. This journey is the struggle and climb in your life. It will be the flow through your life that sometimes resembles a rapid river and sometimes will be more of a small stream. So when you are setting out with your degree in hand to climb the metaphorical highest mountain that's now in front of you, don't look up at the seemingly impossible summit. Keep your eyes in front of you. Just keep going in phases. It is in that effort, in that climb, phase by phase, that you will realize joy and satisfaction that will make your life fulfilling. You will realize that when you reach the top of that mountain, in the moment you turn and look down, there will be an enormous sense of accomplishment for you. You will have earned any title attendant to your feet. But know that titles mean nothing and invite only complacency. You always want to be achieving. You always want to be achieving at some level, adjusted by your life, adjusted by whatever makes you happy. Graduates of 2017, you never want some climb in your life to be over. Congratulations to you and best of luck.
Will all the degree and certificate candidates please rise and stand in place? Mr. President, I have the distinct honor to present to you the degree and certificate candidates of American International College Class of 2017. All have been qualified by the faculty and certified by the registrar to have achieved the requirements of their respective degrees and certificates.
Members of the American International College Class of 2017, by virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees, and subject to the completion of any remaining requirements, I do hereby confer upon you the degree or certificate for which you are qualified and certified with all of the honors, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereunto.
Members of the Class of 2017, please be seated until directed by the marshals to come forward. I am pleased to introduce the student speaker from the Class of 2017, Antoine Bluster. Antoine was selected from among seniors who submitted their speech for review. He's graduating today with a Bachelor of Science in Business Administration. Please join me in welcoming Antoine to the podium.
American International College, Board of Trustees, President Maniachi, distinguished guests, faculty and staff, families, and fellow graduates. Good afternoon. My name is Antoine Bluster, and I represent one of the many voices of this graduating class of 2017. I am honored to be here today to offer words of encouragement, acknowledgement of your accomplishments, reflection of your challenges, and most importantly, a message for your future. Throughout our years here at American International College, we have grown significantly from the encounters and relationships built on campus. Graduates, please take a moment and look around. These are your classmates, best friends, and confidants. These are the people who have helped build that foundation of community and family. Community and family have different meaning to each of us, and diversity and individuality links us together. I am grateful and happy to have had the opportunity to experience true community and family with so many of my fellow graduates. You are all extraordinary. Many of you have established communities in your own ways. Remember the time spent discussing the nursing program and how nursing rotations increase going into your senior year. The time spent chasing around supervisors, trying to find the time in between meetings to get a paper signed for a program on campus. And the hours spent in one-on-one meetings discussing our futures and upcoming programs with the resident directors. The quiet time we have while giving encouragement about how great you will do in the upcoming play, game, and how the injury will not keep you from playing next year. And also discussing the latest details of your occupational and physical therapy courses. I recently finished a book called How Full Is Your Bucket by Tom Rath and his grandfather, Donald Clifton. In this text, they stress the dipper and the bucket, stating, each of us has an invisible bucket. It is constantly emptied or filled, depending on what others say or do to us. When our bucket is full, we feel great. When it's empty, we feel awful. Each of us has an invisible dipper. When we use that dipper to fill other people's buckets by saying or doing things to increase their positive emotions, we also fill our own bucket. But when we use that dipper to dip from others' buckets by saying or doing things to decrease their positive emotions, we diminish ourselves. I don't know about you, but my bucket is consistently overflowing, and I have everyone here to thank for that. We all came to American International College for a reason, an education, a degree, an opportunity to be on a Division I or II athletic team, and a chance to build yourself through thrilling roles in our theater program. Yet, we have gained so much more than we can imagine. Last year, I was in a drought of negativity. Balancing my personal life and all the different components made it that much more challenging. My parents, who are here today, taught me to be strong. They were the perfect example for me to look up to. Growing up with them showed me what a strong man and woman looks like. I have learned to grow thick skin and carry a smile because although the world is a rough place and too rough to stand alone, we must not give up. At AIC, I needed to learn how to support others while also accepting support. There have been tough times, but through our tears, we have encouraged and uplifted each other. Through clinical, we learn how to support and be confident in ourselves and apply our knowledge. In practice, we are supporting each other by challenging our peers and stepping up as well. At work, we learned how to stay calm and strive for excellence. And in the quad, where we practice how to smile and laugh even during our most challenging days. If you have not realized it by now, we have been inducted into the AIC's family. AIC has been with us every step of the way, in the classroom when the professor challenges us to speak up on a shattering topic, and during work study where I have learned to smile through tough times. I have been employed as a resident advisor for 3 years where I learned that I too can give back like so many seniors before us. To our graduate students, taking rigorous courses during the evening and maintaining responsibilities to family and community, we applaud you. You are all extraordinary as well. American International College has made a dedication to us as students. Graduates, it is time to increase our dedication as well. I have discovered that no matter where I am or what position I hold, I will dedicate my positive energy to building a sense of community and family in every relationship and small encounter I have with others, just as this college has done for me. We have increased our intellectual capacity in our chosen fields of science, theater, finance, education, criminal justice, and health science. We must continue to replenish those buckets. I would like to thank our president, Vincent Maniacci, for bringing so much joy and laughter in every encounter we have with him, as well as our friends and family who have traveled from all over the world. It is truly beautiful to see so many faces here in success, in celebration of our success. I do not believe in goodbyes. They are so worn out, prolonged, and sometimes exaggerated. I prefer to say, see you again. This is not the end of the story to anyone here, but the ending of one chapter so another can begin. Congratulations, class of 2017.
Thank you, Antoine. At this time, we would like to recognize those students who achieved the highest academic honor, earning the distinction of valedictorian and salutatorian. The 2017 co-valedictorians are Brittany Burnett and Kimberly Schabowski. The salutatorian is Isabella Olchowski-Dowd. I ask three scholars to please come forward to be recognized. The class of 2017 salutatorian, Isabella Olchowski-Dowd, is a student from Brazil who has completed a double major in marketing and international business. Today, Isabella earns a Bachelor of Science in Business Administration, summa cum laude. Isabella played on the tennis team, serving as captain in her last year. She has been an active member of student government and the Student Athletic Advisory Committee. Her faculty state, she's a hardworking, conscientious student who's a perfectionist. She receives a number of academic awards in both marketing and international business over the past 2 years. She's been accepted to several graduate schools to continue her studies in international marketing. Please join me in congratulating Isabella. Our first co-valedictorian, Brittany Burnett from Wilbraham, Massachusetts, is graduating today with a Bachelor of Arts in Liberal Studies, summa cum laude, with a minor in education. In her 4 years at AIC, Brittany has distinguished herself among her peers and been recognized for excellent academic work by the faculty. The faculty have said she's a scholar with excellent critical thinking skills and exceptional proficiency with the written word. Brittany is a member of the Alpha Chi National Honor Society, and as a member of AIC's Honors Program, she recently presented her senior thesis titled Mind Wandering During Lectures and Its Effects on Performance. Brittany's educational journey will continue as she begins her studies on Monday in AIC's Master of Education program with a focus in elementary education. Please join me in recognizing Brittany. The class of 2017 co-valedictorian Kimberly Schabowski from Ludlow, Massachusetts, who majored in sports and recreation management, is earning a Bachelor of Science in Business Administration, summa cum laude. The faculty described Kim as a dependable and passionate student who has excelled academically while working full-time and actively participating in co-curricular activities. As the founder and president of the Sports and Recreation Management Club, she has initiated several activities for her fellow students, including volunteering for events supporting the Springfield Thunderbirds ice hockey team at job fairs at Fenway Park. She's a member of the Alpha Chi National Honor Society, and this year was the first business major to present at the annual undergraduate research symposium. Kim's aspiration is to become an athletic director at a major university. She is certainly headed in the right direction as she starts a master's program in event operations at Michigan State University this fall. We certainly wish Kim the best. Will the candidates for the Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Science, and Bachelor of Science in Business Administration degrees please rise and come forward?
Mr. President, I have the honor of presenting to you those candidates who have successfully completed the necessary requirements for the Bachelor of Science and the Bachelor of Science in Occupational Science degrees. Maria Luz Alame. Kayla Monique Barnett. Michael Anthony Bardolo. Kelvin Brito. Ashley Danae Brown. Abigail Christine Cavallo. Cum laude, Emily Lynn Cormier. Cum laude, Melanie Corso. Cassandra Kudo. Stephanie Jean Cowell. Andrea Therese Dillon. Tylese Ellis. Ashley Gloria Felix.
Doesn't say.
Courtney Louise Flem. Jessica Fontana. Shireen Germain. Cum laude, Alexia Gooden. Bridget Grimm. Omani Harris. Magna cum laude, Mikhail Kolkowski. Yamilet Lopez Perez. Cum laude, Lassie Blatt Ulrich. Kayla Ortiz. Julia Rose Pasewitz. Kevin Papineau. Ashley Pierre. Paolo Rodriguez. Taylor Ray Rosillo. Falana Sarno. Cum laude, Aaliyah Sullivan. Summa cum laude, Megan Nicole Stewartson. Cum laude, Keisha Trowers. Kenya Tucker. Shaquan Turner. Joshua Weintraub. Ariana Marie Williams. Magna cum laude, Erica Marie D'Angelo. Cum laude, Maeve Elise Denning. Magna cum laude, Emma Hiroth. Cum laude, Kendra Lee Hickson. Magna cum laude, Abigail Esther Hunter. Cum laude, Aisha Martins.
Yes, Aisha!
Summa cum laude, Molly Patrick McQuaid. Yes. Cum laude, Mishek Tango. Cum laude, Carolyn Rose O'Connor. cum laude, Imani Parks. Summa cum laude, Lauren Ashley Pyers. Magna cum laude, Alexandria Marie Rinaldi. Cum laude, Gabriella Starsek. Cum laude, Imani Rose Stepney. Angelica Marie Aiello. Cum laude, Ashley Marie Alvarado. Crystal Anson. Jessica Marie Antonmarshi. Magna cum laude, Emily Rose Barber. Talisha Brown. Stephanie Lynn Katie. Tanisha Camacho. Tamara Campbell.
Great job.
Rachel Elizabeth Perlin. Cum laude, Shanique Campbell Anderson. Melissa Carbone. Victoria Cartagena. Gina Serafini Collins. Elizabeth Aaron Kushan. Sarah Dorothy Dowd. Summa cum laude, Kimberly Lynn Drawick. Kayla Marie Duby. Sarah Ann Dudley. Ashika English. Brooke Stephanie Foss. Megan Lee Gardner. Caitlin Elise Gauthier, cum laude. Samantha Marie Goldapper. Magna cum laude, Nicole Marie Gonzalez. Luis Gonzalez Bonilla. Magna cum laude, Kristen Kim Grant. Kelly Hayward. Magna cum laude, Brianna Marie Harris. Veronica Ho. Helen Nguyen. Jessica Lynn Jenkowitz. Kalia Shanta Johnson. Tara Jones. Tashina Isling Jones Swabby. K2. Danielle Captu. Ashley Marie Kelly. Cassandra Kunkowski. Catherine Alexandra Levantis. Shayna Mackey. Cum laude, Anna Marquez. Cum laude, Nadia Mateo. Marilyn Montanez. Cum laude, Chelsea Morin. Lana Novia. Lily Onefour. Jasmine Odigi. Cum laude, Catherine Oliver. Nicole Paquette. Cum laude, Caitlin Rose Peary. Cum laude, Kayla Lynn Pelletier. Cum laude, Michael James Perez. Cum laude, Kylie Pluta. Kristen Provost. Ashley Putnam. Leandra Raymond. Cum laude, Anna Marjorie Reed. Cum Cum laude, Andre Daniel Ramillard. Brianna Nicole Richardson. Cum laude, Michelle Rondeau. Maddie Russo. Cum laude, Gina Maria Russo. Lourdes Serrano. Maura Shaw. Judith Soto. Cum laude, Catherine Marie Stelzer. Vida Tawa. Michaela Walsh. Camille Catherine Westbrook. Cum laude, Arthur Sterling Yankee.
Mr. President, I have the honor of presenting to you those candidates who have successfully completed the necessary requirements for the Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Science, and Bachelor of Science in Business Administration. Skylar Jordan Adams. Tia A. Altman. Brittany Lynn Burnett, summa cum laude. Elisa Michelle Camargo, cum laude. Christopher Fenn Carter, magna cum laude. Alexa Victoria Cacciatelli. Justin Daniel, cum laude. Drasir Dixon. Devante Dillian, cum laude. Morgan S. Fersky. Deanna Fortin. Kirby J. Grandoid. Salvador Harold. Yeah. Brianna Lee Kenny, cum laude. Amen Kurbanzade, cum laude. Sergiana Lamanchane, cum laude. Anna Bauman, magna cum laude. Montel Darius Miller. Juwan Moody. Marissa Marie Najarian, magna cum laude. Sierra Isabel Naughton, cum laude. Crystal Rose Negrin. Eric Ole Overdahl. Jordan Douglas Page. Marissa A. Phipps. Felicia Pierre. Kelly Riley. Lindsay U. Richmond. Emily Ann Santianello, magna cum laude. Caitlin Ann Sobolewski, cum laude. Kelly Long. Zaida Marie Najiri. Jared Shelby. Francisca Tacchi. Alexis M. Tarosian, magna cum laude. Tabitha Vargas, cum laude. Lamont Harold Waits, cum laude. Aaron A. Yates. Corey A. Acosta. Luke Angelo Allen. Nukaya Isabel Antoine. Anthony R. Appleton. Jillian Bedard, cum laude. Shayna S. Blamasa, cum laude. Ahmed Bracero, Dida. Jashane David Brown. Khadija Brown. Ashley Marie Cardinal, cum laude. Kamel I. Cartwright, cum laude. Khadija M. Mendez. Kaheem Elijah Finley. Bianca Isabel Mensa. Ashley Cyrus. Eleni Anna Fulop, cum laude. Samantha B. Ramirez. Shantia S. Chapman. Alexia F. Kopich. Benjamin James Cucci. Ashley A. Craig. Jessica Nicole Dahlquist. Luciana Gabriel Di Rienzo. Rico Facey. Jessica Genius. Elaine L. Guan. Angela Camille Guin, cum laude. Ariel Hillman. Shay Elizabeth Homer. Stephanie Marie Horton. Andrew William Iovana. Ayana Tira Jacobs. Gianna Jensen, summa cum laude. Kyle Matthew Kazakinas. Sarah A. Landaverde, cum laude. Trevon Levert Lattimore. Jessica L. Lawler, summa cum laude. Errol George Lee. Emily Rose Marini, cum laude. Brittany Elizabeth McCarthy. Tanisha Lynn Moyer, magna cum laude. Emily Ann Murray, cum laude. Maggie Patricia O'Rourke. Kenesha Looney Pierre Noel. Tiana Giselle Powell. Sheldon J. Roden. Corey G. Roselle. Bianca M. Santianello, cum laude. Serena L. Shutter, magna cum laude. Francesca Naomi Torres. Shantoy M. Usher. Natalie Shanice Velez. Nicholas Michael Vumbaco. Jasmine Nadine White, cum laude. Kevin White. Derek Robert White. Ariana C. Williams, cum laude. Dynasty Deshae Wilson. Melanie Young, summa cum laude. DeAndre Denali Alston. Garrett Andrew Augustin. Cameron Philip Beaulieu, magna cum laude. Antoine Bluster. Andre F. Rolim. Yeah, Mitchell Burns, summa cum laude. John Chariot Churcher. Pascaline Jeritich, cum laude. Kimberly J. Schabowski, summa cum laude. Isabella Olchowski Doubt, summa cum laude. Daniel E. Belair, cum laude. Christopher Bottler. Samuel Akwaze Buanbang, cum laude. Dominique D. Kamek. Nicole N. Campbell Chambers. Emily E. Chang, cum laude. Mark Cohen. Marcel Robert DePina. Nyasia S. Dubois. Which Valence Exelholm. Paulo M. Fragoso, summa cum laude. Nicholas Green. Lamar Tariq Grogan, magna cum laude. Carson G. Grola, summa cum laude. Blake Robert Gergel. Tabina Gardner. Niles Alexander Hightower. Jacob Michael Kruger. Natalia Kruger, cum laude. Paul A. Leite. Alexia C. Dice, summa cum laude. Frederick Hunter Leisner, magna cum laude. Justin J. Lewis, magna cum laude. Brian Joseph Lazat, summa cum laude. John Joseph Magliano. Sue Ellen Macrianis, cum laude. Shannon L. Mullane, cum laude. Corey Momsen. Casey Navarro. Jonathan Ortiz. Monique Ardelia Owens, cum laude. Rebecca E. Gray. Joseph Michael Petrone, summa cum laude. Dominic Anthony Racoboldo, magna cum laude. Ashley Marie Ricard. Akeem Delroy Sharif. Kristen Elizabeth Steele. Samuel Raymond Stockhammer, magna cum laude. Sebastian Tomeo. Shaquille Roan Taylor. Wasim V. Thomas. Austin Thomas Valley, cum laude. Henry Vilfort. Michelle Cassandra Vital. Curtis Werner. Russell C. West. Anthony Stephen Wonenberg. Demetria E. Wood.
Will the candidate for the Master of Arts, Master of Science, Master of Education degrees, and the Certificate of Advanced Graduate Studies please rise and come forward?
Mr. President, I have the honor of presenting to you those candidates who have successfully completed the necessary requirements for the Master of Business Administration and Master of Science in Accounting and Taxation. Carolyn F. Brennan. Nicole Marie Brunson. Tiana R. Craig. Zachary E. Detour. Raymond Durrett. Maurice J. Easterling. Vincent Esposito. Devante Ginyard. Jonathan R. Jubilee. Jenny Labassiere. Crystal Mallett. Anae Sheriron. Omari Manhertz. Tyrone William Manns. Jessica Margareta. Emmanuel McLean. Kira McKelvey. Matthew John Moore. Brian Manuel Ortiz. Melissa Prisbytek. Jeffrey D. Senkowitz. Calvin Kendu Stanley.
I'm doing two groups.
Javon Gary Williams. William Waleo Wemaga. William S. Belansky. Brian Boodoo. Ryan Boohoo. Dayantaban Virajzin Mahida. Hamza Farooq. James Warrell Turgeon.
Mr. President, I have the honor of presenting to you those candidates who have successfully completed the necessary requirements for the Certificate of Family Nurse Practitioner and for the Master of Science in Nursing degree. Michelle Cooper. Marisol Ramos. Florence Edgy. Amanda Bryant. Isarilis Claudia Ortiz. Sarah J. Dollhouse. Mary A. House. Ann Mastro Totaro. Gina Marie Prickett. Terrell Anthony Saunders. Laura Sibelli. Colleen Ann Thiebault. Jennifer R. Wilson. Mr. President, I have the honor of presenting to you those candidates who have successfully completed the necessary requirements for the Master of Science in Occupational Therapy degree. Mallory Dawn Anderson. Megan Rose Black. Andrea Boxen. Patricia Fatima Dos Santos. Allison Nicole Martin. Ashley Mercier. Nathan David Pruce. Anna Margot Ramon. Patricia Christine Swake. Savas Antonios Valas.
Mr. President, I have the honor of presenting to you those candidates who have successfully completed the necessary requirements for the Master of Arts in General Psychology, Master of Arts in Clinical Psychology, and Master of Science in Forensic Psychology. Nermeen Bushra. Alicia Jordan Miller. Mercedes N. Minaya. Thelma A. Kyrim. Megan Marie Mayamiak. Christopher J. Ryan. Lachelle D. Taylor Boyd. Raheem Allen. Elizabeth Marie Charpentier. Mary M. Crotty. Jessica Lynn Hall. Rebecca Trinks DeWald. Nadia Ruiz. Christina Gedeon. Dallas B. Ortiz. Sarah E. Hart. Sabrina Sharon Evangelisto. Jessica Rodriguez. Tanya Lynn Picking. Iris Caraballo. Sherry Falsetti. Olivia C. Figuera. Ronya Maria Haig. Brianna Renee Haygood. Ashley Mercedes Hernandez. Jesse Stephen Murray. Lenroy A. Naismith. Jalpa Patel. Callahan Porsche. Wanda V. Shepherd. Renee Mary Stewart. Jamal Eric Tart. Gabriella Selena Trespla. Samantha E. Weber.
Mr. President, I have the honor of presenting to you those candidates who have successfully completed the necessary requirements for the Master of Arts in Counseling Psychology degree. Whitney Dodds. Gina M. Hale. Samantha Simone Hamilton. Jennifer Marie Innocenti. Benjamin Leahy. Nancy N. Methenge. Heather Marie Petraeus Gladu. Is that it?
Mr. President, I have the honor of presenting to you those candidates who have successfully completed the necessary requirements for the Master of Education and the Master of Education in Educational Psychology degrees. Valerie Jude Alves. John G. Andrade. Ashley Costa Barbosa. Katie Lynn Bartlett. Laura C. Bentley. Gregory Joseph Burt. Angela M. Bettinelli. Kristen K. Villapacqua Copa. Alyssa Bishop. Kyla M. Bivens. Megan Tande Bradley. Samantha Aureli Buckley. Raleigh Joan Brennan. Wayne R. Brumbaugh. Victoria Elizabeth Cardillo. Alexandra Catherine Case. Drew Cofello. Thomas E. Collins. Lori Miller Connolly. Kristen Lynn Crumwick. Caitlin Elizabeth D'Alessio. Jennifer H. Daly. Julie Ann Davison. Lauren M. Deyotas. Jennifer Lynn Duranus. Samantha E. DiGiovanni. Gail Lynn Donovan. Seema Sanjeev Gupta. Leah Sunshine Dow. Jean C. DeLong.
Try to speak into a microphone, it's hard to hear.
I am, of course. Michelle Hernandez. Marjorie Denise Dunlap. Taylor Lee Dyer. Raven East. Kimberly Ehrlich. Richard S. Elliott. Alicia Sue Fubella. Justine Elizabeth Ferrara. Heather Lynn Fish. Ashley Jean Fitzler. Alex James Frijo. Christina Marcella Gallagher. Mary Ellen Gray. Jessica Galicia. Lisa Hall. Elizabeth Marie Hathaway. Matthew Sewell Hay. Angelique B. Husbands. Erica M. Hyam. Jennifer A. Johnson. Amanda K. Hett. Elise Ann Johnson Dreyer. Andrea Madeline Kumagian. Jason M. Cusey. Courtney A. Lefebvre. Rebecca Lair. Joseph S. Lima. William Scott McComber. Aaron F. Mahoney. Eileen C. Maza. Courtney M. McCarthy. Lisa Marie McIntyre. Adam Manuel Melville. Jill Ann Mormon. Sylvia Mendez Maroney. Katie Jean Marie Murphy. Kimberly Mae Murphy. Stephanie Allison Nartal. Abraham Osario. Kristen Lee Peterson. J. Jillian A. Perry. Kristen Ann Pisano. Cara A. Plant. Kyla Marie Pravia. Nadia Ruganoff. Andrew James Raposo. Cindy J. Rennie. Sherry L. Riccardi.
Not as proud as our softball championship.
Faith Ashley Roberts. Jennifer Susan Russell. Christine Scott. Jessica Ann Scott. Naomi S. Sinez. Paul R. Scoville. Benjamin Senior. Hiral C. Shah. Allison Sheedy. Maritha Sidebottom. Jennifer Marie Suwa. Stephanie M. Soares. Nicole Sousa. Stephanie Sousa. Pamela Megan Spencer. Cordelia Taki. Nancy E. Teller. Twi Tron. Karen M. Vale. Amanda Lauren Vieira. K. M. Vigil. Angela Walsh. Kelly Madeline Winslow. Tamara Lee Wozniak. Mackenzie Copley. Mary K. Kavanaugh. Indira Melissa DeJesus. Nancy J. Kilpatrick. Jennifer Lee Leandro Silva. Latronda Macmillan. Valente Daniel Tulock Sr.
No, same thing. Certificate advanced that. Certificate advanced degree.
Mr. President, I have the honor of presenting to you those candidates who have successfully completed the necessary requirements for the Certificate of Advanced Graduate Study. Sandra L. Alton. Felix Caraballo. Matthew Lee Collins. Ada De La Cruz. Alan Douglas Peterson.
Will the candidates for the Doctor of Physical Therapy, and Doctor of Education degrees, please rise and come forward.
Mr. President, I have the honor of presenting to you those candidates who have successfully completed the necessary requirements for the Doctor of Physical Therapy degree. Daniel Jonathan Bax. Brianna Ashley Bishop. Nicholas Kajekis. Molly Ann Course. Michael John Coyne. Danielle A. D'Adamio. Olivia Claire Di Matteo. Maurice Patrick Disley the Fourth. Stephanie Lynn Dufresne. Alicia N. Fassett. Christine Burnell Gonzalez. Rebecca E. Hardy. Jacqueline Hennen. Quan Ko. Joshua Alexander Kudo. Anthony Michael Laurinaitis. Michael James Laviolette. Amanda Martins. Timothy Joseph McNamara. Danielle Marie Murphy. Brian Tan Nguyen. Anthony M. Santoro. Meredith Lee Sincere. Alexandra Isabella Stasek. Stephen Michael Strong. Nora A. Julius. Christopher Wilson.
Mr. President, I have the honor of presenting to you those candidates who have successfully completed the necessary requirements for the Doctor of Education and Doctor of Education in Educational Psychology. Karen Kanata Boydston. Leticia Charmaine Boyles. Donald G. Coombs. Kelly Marie Georgie. Deborah Macedo Goulart. Amy Lynn Martin. Jan E. Moonsey. Susan Florence O'Reilly McRae. Anne Marie Rodriguez. Felix Oponquason. Kelly M. Celeste. Kendra Matat.
I am pleased to present a proud AIC alumnus, Mr. James C. Hagen, class of 88, MBA class of 88, and honorary doctorate 2017, who will provide the induction into the Alumni Association.
Good afternoon. Thank you, everyone. Graduates, your journey to earn your degree has ended. You are now on a path to be successful in your careers. From this day forward, you will forever be known as alumnus of American International College. I would like to congratulate you, your family, and the dedicated faculty on the completion of your degree. There is, however, one last ritual. Graduates, please move your tassel to the left side of your mortarboard to symbolize that you've earned your degree. You look good, you look good. As an alumnus of the class of 1988, I take great privilege and sincere honor in inducting the class of 2017 into the ranks of American International College alumni. Would everyone please stand and welcome our newest alumni?
I would like to now ask everyone to remain standing for benediction.
Gracious God, we're so proud of these graduates who have discovered much about the world and themselves through AIC. May they continue to discover what gives life deep meaning, something worth living for, maybe even dying for, something that energizes them, enthuses them, and enables them to keep moving forward. We can't tell them what that is. That's for them to discover, to choose, and to love. For nothing is more practical than falling in love in a quite absolute and final way. What you are in love with, what seizes your imagination, will affect everything. It will decide what will get you out of bed in the morning, what you do with your evenings, how you spend your weekends, what you read and whom you know. It will decide what breaks your heart and amazes you with joy and gratitude. Gracious God, help them to fall in love and stay in love. It will decide everything. Amen.
Mr. Chair, Mr. President, ladies and gentlemen, graduates of the class of 2017, I declare the 2017 commencement of American International College to be complete. And on behalf of the AIC family, I wish all the mothers in the audience, a happy Mother's Day. Thank you.
got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night.
Tonight's the night. Let's live it up. I got my money. Let's spin it up. Go out and smash it. Like, oh my God. Jump off that sofa. Let's kick it.